Hi guys, welcome back to our channel.
Hi guys, my name is Femi.
I'm your cousin.
Oh really? Wow. Okay, so today we're going to be doing some Twitter rants. Twitter talks. That statement. We're going to be talking about what's happening on Twitter and our responses to
this Rona season, reactions in this Rona season.
Yeah. So let's start.
Let's get it. So, you know, this morning I was scrolling through my phone and something that blew my imagination was, you know, you know that thing, you know when you sing that song, automatically like white dots appear on your finger.
Lies.
Now somebody on Twitter is telling me that, oh, let me tell you what the person said. Probably it's because we probably lack nutrients like zinc or even calcium, or add minor injuries that the nail blade and numerous things that cost it. I want to knock my 5-year-old self in the head right now. Uncle, what are you talking about? When you injure yourself on your nail, it don't look like leke leke. Leke leke is a distinct type of injury. Of dots. Once you sink to the bed, it passes by and dots you.
So how does it dot you? Like,
I think it's when the bird just passed and like it's like dropping
poo poo.
It's like dropping poo poo.
It's not bird poo.
It's
just like it's something. The thing was a miraculous thing that the Lord brought along with the leke leke. So leke leke, bami leke, eya bami leke. And all of a sudden the white one appeared. So uncle is telling me about zinc and calcium. Hello.
Oh,
we all know that those major things are things that we lack. Not in childhood. People are still lacking it. We can't get enough calcium anywhere. So please remove calcium and zinc from it. It has nothing to do with that. Just leave it. It was leke leke that gave us the dots. Is that clear?
Okay.
Is that clear, uncle? Please. Okay. Don't destroy it. Thank you very much.
Topic should be the one about the father beating his child because of a bad result. So let's start with that. And to me, oh, the beating was a normal African parent beating a child for a bad result. But the thing is that in this time and age, when you keep on beating your child, it's like you're beating them to be goats. Because they're not going to hear. That beating is not going to change the child's improvement in school. Just make good to make the child more heady. That's just what me I feel.
I don't think parents used to beat their children for bad results. Not beat, but shout and scold. Like in this house, did they ever beat us for bad results, Tai?
I was getting there. Like me, in primary school and till GS1, I wasn't doing well. Like, when my sisters wake up in the middle of the night to read, I wake up in the middle of the night and be eating. Like, why are people reading? What's going on? I got my GS1 result, I remember vividly. F, P, C. I never got an A.
Okay,
my dad did not say you are... He did not even lift a finger.
But he was like, just called
you could
you
do better. Like, you can like, do yeah. better. That you... hey. Like, the beating for me was... It was people were saying, oh, it didn't even beat him that, oh, they would have done proper smackdown, you know, you scared. I'm like, you people are like, you're justifying him beating his son. Like, eventually at the end of the day, we will train our children the way we want to train our children.
It's not about smackdown, but the boy's face was red.
And like, I've already made it, like, registered it in my heart. I will not flog my child. I won't flog.
Personally, I feel that was, it wasn't called for, because every failure is also a stepping stone to success. There are better ways to deal with issues about school and the rest, because it really doesn't make sense. Because I failed, you want to like hit me. SS3, whether right, he has a very good exam to write in that SS3 period, but you don't just react in the heat of the moment.
Mm-hmm.
There are better ways to deal with things.
Yeah.
You call your son aside, why did you meet this class?
Mm-hmm.
What happened? What really went wrong?
Mm-hmm.
That you don't just, and the person that was videoing that
is his mother. The mother was
Georgie.
I'm like,
do you know what the mother was recording the video
and then for giving us a topic of discussion shiny when during this corona period. Honestly, that person did not help at all,
because I'm like, there are so many things you can do, like, than flogging the child. And for the fact that the child is in SS3, so from GS1 till now, has he been succeeding? If he has been succeeding, then that slap was really unnecessary. If he has been failing, then that slap is unnecessary, because you know your son has been failing since GS1. What have you done about it? My son has been passing, but he just failed once. I was slapping. Why? Like, there's so many things involved. Like, just beating your child, I feel, is unnecessary. And beating will not change anything. Yeah, people say that, oh, they've seen their friends that they beat them and they change. But no, their change is short-lived. It's short-term. And if it's long-term, good for them. But I will not lay a finger on my child because of academic failure, because it does not do anything. It does not. It does not. People are not saying that, oh, $21,000. I'm like, you sent him. Did he send you to a school that they are paying $21,000?
I will not say that thing.
The thing is that
train up a child in the way you want him to go, and when he grows old, he will not depart from it. Let's not lie. So now, in that case of the 21,000 naira school fees or $B school fees, is that
USD, baby?
USD. The school did not try. You did not see a child in the hall for exam. Why didn't you summon the child? Why didn't you when you know this kind of child used to misbehave, why didn't you tell the parents to make sure their child was in the hall? Because they were saying absent mass, absent English, meaning that omolomo kolosi exam or kolokawe
is a alright secretary shaku license.
Like, there are other good schools. I'm sure there are other good schools there that are not that expensive.
It's not even
so
about...
So, like, you should not say, oh, $21,000. Everybody, because everybody's, like, screaming. $21,000. Yes, I know it's a lot of money. Yes, it is. But I didn't ask to be sent to that school. I'm not saying, okay, I'm not, like, justifying...
She's not justifying the child's bad behavior. She's just saying that the man should have not solely kept on throwing
emphasizing the facts about
the money.
Yeah,
do you understand? Okay, you guys realize that, like, 21 US is a lot of money, but if he can afford,
like, that
it's a lot of money. But you know, if he was like Kim K rich or something, that's not a lot of money. That's like money for,
like,
Hermes bag, Chanel or something. But what I'm trying to say is that, like, see, that's the money that you're paying for the school fees is really none of the child's dirty business. It's you that put that child in that school. So that's on you. So my thing is that if you were really concerned about the money from the beginning, you should have been monitoring your child like a hawk. Period. The progress of your child.
People are now saying that, oh, so because I'm a parent, I should now lose myself in my child. Parenting is not...
It's not
a one-day job.
It's a lifetime job. Excuse me. Parenting is losing your life in your child.
No.
Till when they can have their own sense. Like, what do you mean by lose?
Because
No, but it's not... I don't know how to explain it to you, but I'm
it's
trying
not
to
like
you
losing
like,
yourself, not losing yourself.
It's like involving your child in your life.
You realize in this time of age, people don't, you know, back then, people wanted to have children because they wanted someone to look after and care for,
and
they were
their attention on.
But now people are more selfish. Some people don't even want
very
to have any
people
children.
People are more selfish now.
Some people don't
want to... lot are selfish out there.
Some people don't want to have children, not for tangible reasons, fam.
They want to have children
for... Oh, I don't want to... My body shape.
Yes.
Or, oh, I can't give myself.
Mm-hmm.
Or, I can't... So, that person that made that comment of, so you should lose yourself, and the person made it from a selfish place.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Saying that, okay, mistakes that my child made at a certain age, I shouldn't be held accountable for. It's not like the boy is 24.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like he's 18. Even if he's 18, for God's sake. Do you understand? It is your... You know that he's writing an important exam in his life.
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't you sit down with him? Why didn't
exactly.
you... Well, the boy shall pass musical. They say the boy passed
musical.
Some people were saying that they should carry the boy to music school. Send your son to music school, set.
Don't mind them. I think that comment was just like crazy.
It just didn't call for it. It wasn't necessary at all.
It wasn't called for.
There are better ways to to discipline him. He failed an exam. Quite all right. That was you.
Even Waek, what am I saying? Just what? In Waek, what did I get in maths? D. I got mad. Is that not enough for them to flog me?
Is that not enough for them to flog you guys, me? You know, look, let's look at the parent, let's look at the father's angle. Now we're looking at, we've all gone through the child.
We've come to that conclusion that you should, let me tell, I'm for beating, but beating
for
with purpose. Not beating because you are angry.
Beating with boundaries.
Beating because you need to, maybe the child is deaf. There's some children that, generally deaf guy, stubborn ones that you can correct, but once they're like, what, once they're like 12, I don't think you should be beating them anymore because there's no hope, there's no turning back. So you shouldn't beat for because they failed something. You should beat to correct maybe some attitude that you can, you can't use your words, you can, you've tried every means. Beating should be the, like, the last resort, and not beating to paralyze or beating because you are angry. Your emotions is irrelevant in this case.
I feel that beating,
keep it in check.
Beating him, like, I feel that we, like, parents, they should teach their children that when you fail, it's not the end. Because right now, what he just did right then, he literally just, like, made him have another perception of failure. I'm not saying it's not good to fail an exam. If you fail an exam, life goes on. I'm teaching that you can do something better. Not that you just come out beating him because he failed that. That was a very crucial exam. But that doesn't mean that you should just come and beat him out of anger.
What
there are better ways.
He beat him just
in what you guys realize that the father, in that video, that father was talking about stigmatization when it comes to failing of results. I mean, I was wondering why the father was putting that in the boy's ear. The thing is that he has failed and he has failed.
But he was don't, like, oh, it's on your record and everything.
Yes, boy, the thing is
that rewrite
you can rewrite it and become better.
The grades failed. The grades failed 20 times.
Of great people.
Exactly, Ben Cassidy is a perfect example.
Because
he failed over
and over again. Even from our leaders in Nigeria, they were
So like, I don't get like people are saying some people were saying, oh, you are trying to form woke. No, I'm not trying to form woke.
We woke. We are woke. Work. If woke means having sense and saying the right thing, bro, I'm woke.
I'm not trying to say that, oh, okay, you put that between your children, you are demons.
And you should actually be woke. Do you realize that?
This issue of beating, like, in modern days, is actually creating a lot of controversy because everybody's always like, don't beat your children. People want to beat their children. Some people just beat for the wrong reason.
Some people beat because, what they call it, oh, their parents beat them. Me too, I'm gonna frog my children. What's that? I in secondary school, I'm a senior, the punishment.
That's a trip. That's some
sense.
Funny stuff.
Doesn't work. Can you tell me you were saying
that? I feel that, like, people are always like, my parents don't understand me. They don't do this. And we the present generation, like, they should beat him, they should do this, they should do that. I feel that if you think your parents don't understand you, the way they react, they choose to react to some of your actions. If you actually want to rewrite their wrongs, you shouldn't be behaving
the same to your child.
Doing the same idea to correct your child because there are better ways.
Yes.
We are the new generation. We should think. We should.
But then you will realize that the problem is that some people are like, I don't want to be like my parents. I don't want to be like my parents. Because they put that as a driving force. You realize most people that say, I don't want to be like my parents. I don't want to be like they become their parents.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's just because they're saying it in their mind, but they're not taking practical steps and trying to make changes. They're just like, I don't want to be my parents. I don't want. By the time you realize it, 10 years later, I am my parents.
So, like, basically, me, I already, like, I won't, like I said earlier on, I won't flog my child.
What?
I have so many things for you to do, like, when I give you those things.
But you punish them.
You punish them.
Yes, but not.
They won't pick pin.
You won't pick pin.
Ah, guy, you go pick pin. Oh, my God.
You punish me with them.
Guy, you pick pin. Don't worry.
You think about your life.
Physical.
You think about your life.
But let's all agree that the father was, I'm going to say, the father was beating him from
a frustrating and emotional part of his being.
Someone was telling me that the father was expressing his feelings. I'm like,
that's the right statement.
Why?
She said it's the right statement, but that doesn't mean it's the right thing to do.
Because you know what? You know the thing is that the way that man reacted to the boy's failure is the same way that maybe they trained him in his house. Or it's the same way somebody has done to him and it has become like an habit. Because God, even after the wife was still trying to tame him, the father was still going all
night.
Don't talk about the wife.
That woman was a problem.
Why did she record it and could not even stand in front of her son and
She was putting pillow.
Like, really? Please, let's move to another topic.
So, and again, you will realize that there's a very high probability that that man, oh my God, Igboshin school.
Exactly.
Honestly.
Basketball.
And
you failed.
What people are not forgetting, they should, like, the after effects of what this man has done to his child. I feel like if he goes out, yes, people will still remember. This Twitter.
Internet, never.
I'm telling you,
internet never sleeps. They never forget that.
They won't forget that
internet.
Fact. They're going to go
never
out another time.
Never
like,
forget.
Oh, you are that boy that.
That is the stigma.
That's the stigma
that the father and mother originally created for him.
That was the wrong period.
This is what, like, a typical Nigerian parent, this is how they will react, like, normally. But
I would say African.
It doesn't make it right.
Don't say Nigerian, say African.
African,
because
sorry.
There's some Nigerian parents that never leave their finger on their
it
child.
It doesn't make it right. And it's not just today that said that I'll beat my child. It's since I was in primary school.
Today you said that you will not beat your child.
That's in primary school. My brother.
Okay.
Never mind.
Thank you guys for watching this episode.
Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, turn on the notification bell and share, please. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye, guys.